nice to talk to someone who wasn't like, well, you know,
I did it like this.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm Danielle Brooks, and this is A Little Bit Pregnant. Each episode, I'm talking to the experts about pregnancy, parenthood, and everything in between. This episode, what in the doula?
All right, y'all.
I'm gearing up. I got 6 weeks to go before this baby comes out of me. And I keep hearing about doulas, and I know nothing about them. Maybe a little bit. I hope you'll come with me and learn as we talk to the experts. In the meantime, hydrate.
I'm very, very scared of childbirth. That's why I'm going to hire a doula. You know what a doula is? That's a white hippie witch that blows quinoa into your to Kaiser Soze all the pain away.
I'm here with Domino Kirke. I'm super excited to have her. And she's one of the co-founders of Carriage House Birth. You know what I was going for. Anyway, can you please break down? Talk to me about doulas. Just educate us, because we need help.
Doulas are emotional, informational, spiritual, mm-hmm. physical support for the laboring person mm-hmm. and the family.
I just want to talk about the difference between a midwife and a doula. Because when I first came in, I was like, I thought they was the same thing. Mm-hmm. And they're totally really not, right?
Midwives are medical professionals. They're medically trained. They can do everything except surgery.
And the difference with the doula is, between the midwife, mm-hmm. is that the doulas can't necessarily deliver.
No, we're not catching your babies.
Okay, you know, but have you caught a few?
I have.
So how early in the process do you think one should even bring in a doula?
I mean, as early as they can, but we, as doulas, we get called like at 37 weeks. Like, oh my God, I heard I need
really?
A doula. I need you. Like, tell me everything. Can I meet you once?
That late?
And some people pee on a stick and we're hired.
And how is it for doulas working with dads?
We like to say partners because
okay.
they're not
partners,
always male.
That's true.
The person in labor just starts to vomit or there's a lot of blood or a big thing that could be scary. Mm-hmm. The partner looks at the doula and is like, well, if they're not scared, I guess everything's fine. So we're like we gauge the room. Partners end up loving doulas because we relax them and give them less to do so they can hone in on you.
Which is nice. Mm-hmm. Okay, give me an example of what a doula would actually do while I'm in labor.
One way that doulas tend to tell people how to breathe is just circular breathing.
Okay.
So you might completely like ditch this when you go into labor and be like, okay. I don't know what she was talking about. But one way.
Like, I'm breathing. I'm breathing. I'm breathing.
But one way is really to just take it in through your nose really long and slow and blow it out of your mouth. And as you blow it away, you're also blowing away the tension that is in your shoulders and your neck. And so you can really feel how that circular breathing is moving through your body versus like, you know, the in and out of your mouth or holding your breath until it's done. Circular breathing is actually just moving everything through.
So what are some tips for people who can't afford a doula, who might not want a doula? Mm-hmm.
One thing about people who can't afford one, there really is a doula for everyone. So people, there are volunteer services. People,
okay.
It's much more the category of people who just feel like they don't need that kind of thing. But let me tell you, those people always end up calling someone.
One tip, what would it be?
Picking your team is so huge.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter what hospital you're in, or what place you're in, as long as the people there are for you. Make sure they're the kind of people that you could take a poop in.
We talked to Domino, but I also heard about postpartum doulas. Did you know that was a thing? Okay, y'all. So I am here with my friend Tedecia, and she is just golden. She's a new mother of, how old is your son?
7 months old today.
7 months old today.
Yeah.
And you said this thing moves fast.
So
huh?
fast. So fast.
Well, I need your help. I need your knowledge.
I'm going to give it all.
Give it to us.
To you.
Give it to
yes.
us.
Because I'm constantly receiving it. Anytime I see a mom, I'm just like, what do you do? What's your secret?
Yes.
You know?
So, I want to talk to you about the doula thing.
Okay.
Did you know about doulas before being pregnant?
I didn't know about doulas okay. before being pregnant. When me and my partner, Curtis, together. He was just like, we don't need a doula. Like, I've got you.
So you didn't get pre-doula, if that's the thing.
Right.
Which is, I guess, was really called just a doula.
Just a doula.
And you did something called post-doula.
Yeah.
Well, did she live with you?
No, she'll come over for like a couple of hours, 3 hours at a time. She'll ask me how everything is going, give me any advice that I need, any questions that I have. She's incredibly knowledgeable. She's a baby wearing expert, so she taught me how to
wrap the baby
and wear him, which gave me an immense amount of freedom.
Did she talk to you about breastfeeding?
Everything. She's a lactation consultant, so she taught me about breastfeeding. But more than that, she would always bring me a cooked lunch. She would wash,
she cooks for you,
wash my dishes, take out my trash, make sure make sure we were both down for a nap before she left.
You might have to drop me her number.
No, she's amazing. Yeah.
So, did you have any misconceptions about doulas before using one?
Yeah, I just didn't realize how essential they could be.
I think I'm going to do the doula.
You should do
and
it.
I'm into this postpartum doula if my mom's not available.
Well, it was nice to have an objective opinion. It was nice to talk to someone who wasn't like, well,
I did it like this.
Yeah, exactly.
Did you feel judgment with that? Like, mamas be like, you can't handle this on your own?
I'm from a Jamaican family. Okay. So, like, my mom was just like, what is this doula? After hearing about it and realizing what a help it was for me, she was like, oh, this is really cool.
Do you feel like because it's such a luxury that sometimes maybe you can find that within a friend or...
Yeah, definitely. We were so fortunate that we were gifted that.
Yeah.
And, like, that was really amazing. The things that I have learned from having a postpartum doula, I have passed on to other people. Simple things like do a list of things that you would like your guests to know when they come through the door.
Ooh,
so that you don't have to
say it. Sometimes you still got to say it.
Right, exactly.
If you had one tip that you would give any mother, what would that be?
It's what we were just talking about. Allow yourself to be helped. It's okay to be held and carried by your friends, by your family, by whoever your support network is. It really is about the village, and it truly takes a village.
Yes.
And for the village to work properly, it means that you have to be in a place of receiving.
Allow yourself to be helped. I'm here for that.
Yeah.
My favorite phrase while being pregnant is, no, I'm pregnant. Can you put your earring in? No, I'm pregnant. Can you do the dishes tonight? No, I'm pregnant. Can you order the pizza? No. I'm pregnant. Help me get up, girl. Help me.
I'm just kidding. I'm practicing.
Yeah, you got it.